Hello, in this class of GSM, we will be studying about GSM handovers. So, why handovers are required and what do you mean by handover? Handover means that passing access in order to maintain mobility. As user, that means we require user require mobility, that means moving from one area to another area. But if I am under this cell and the coverage extended up to this much area, I require to move from this area to another area. So if I don't have any provision of handover, so my call will be dropped at this point. Because for this particular mobile station, I am under this area. So when I started moving from this, by default I am not getting the coverage. So my call will be dropped. So in order to maintain mobility of the users, mobility of the mobile stations, that means there should not be any call drops when moving. So we have a provision of handover. My first, that means passing access from one cell to another cell for continuous mobility of mobile station is known as handover process. So the question is that why handover is required? Handover is required in a system so that we have mobility and there should not be any call drops. User will get seamless handover, that is continuous coverage and continuous mobility. So that's why we have a provision of handovers, that we're passing access from one cell to another cell. This is for this particular mobile station. Now, how handover will occur? That what is the handover criteria? So, what happened? Consider that I am under this cell. So, it is sending me coverage. So, suppose that its coverage extended up to this much area. At this particular location, that means when I am near to the cell, this is known as near cell. Far, or I can say this is my cell edge. Also name it as cell center or center cell. So I am getting, that means I means the mobile station is getting two parameters, which is RX level and reception quality. So this mobile station is getting two values from the network, RX level and RX quality. RX level and RX quality will tell this mobile station the quality and the level of the signal which this user or this mobile station is getting. When I am close to the cell or I am in the center cell or near cell, so I am getting good coverage. So good coverage means that my RX level and RX quality values are also good. But when I started moving, coverage will decrease and RX level and RX quality will also decrease. So whenever I'm moving in a poor coverage area, that means, okay, I started moving. I will draw this again. Okay. Mobile station started moving. When it goes to a poor coverage area, this mobile station will send MR to mobile station. MR means measurement reports. So what is there in these MR reports or measurement reports? In MR reports, we have two parameter values again. which is RX level and RX quality. So this BTS will analyze that this mobile station is getting in a poor coverage area. So I require to have a handover, provide it a handover to another cell. Because RX level and RX quality of another cell will be good. Now, if it has value 10 and it has a value 15, so value 15 will be good as compared to cell 10. So I will demand a handover to another cell. So I am sending a message, I am sending a reports, and these reports are known as measurement reports. And after analysis that okay, this mobile station is getting very poor quality, so I will automatically generate a handover request to another nearby cell, so that this mobile station will get good coverage and good values in different cell, under different cell. So that means passing access for this mobile station, this BTS is passing access to another cell or another BTS. This process is known as handover process. That means passing a handover from one to another for continuous mobility. Now, a handover types. That means how many types of handovers we have. So, handovers are of two types. Hard handover and second one is soft handover. Hard handover and soft handover. That means handovers are divided into two categories, hard and soft. Hard handover is known as break before make, and soft handover as make before break. These are my two categories. Hard handover and soft handover. GSM is working on hard handover criteria, whereas CDMA and the WCDM working on soft handover. Now, what is hard, break before make? Let's understand handover with one example. This hand is my one cell and this is another cell. And this is a call, that means mobile station. So, when it starts moving, it getting in a poor coverage area. So in hard handover, I have to break before make. So I will break, then break. First we will break the connection, then it will attach with the new cell. That means this cell is breaking a connection with this mobile station, and at the same time this is making a connection. Whereas in soft handover, we have a make before break scenario. So it will make first, after making it will break. So these are the type of handover: break before make, you have to break before making a new connection, you have to make before breaking a previous connection. So handovers are of two types or categories: hard handover and soft handover. Our GSM is working on hard handover. That means in GSM we have a handover in which we will break first before make. So these are the major categories that okay, hard GSM requires hard handover or soft. So GSM is working on hard handover. But under hard handover category also, that means if I categorize handover on a broader sense, so I have a handovers like in, I will write first here. Inter cell handover. That means between two different cells, you require to provide a handover. So if I make it as this one as my one site, so from this cell, one cell to another cell. That means between different cells, we require to provide a handover. So I have another this one as 3, 4, 5, 6, 3. Now, when from one site to another site, we require to provide a handover. Or I can say this is also known as inter BTS handover. So from BTS A to BTS B, we require to provide a handover, which is known as inter BTS handover or inter cell handover, cell on a broader sense. But whenever I require to provide a handover within a cell, that means from one to this, I can say between sectors. I require a handover, but handover that I require is between sector from alpha to beta to gamma. This is known as softer handover or intracell. This one as softer handover. The softer handover is a hand. No doubt, softer handover is also hard handover because GSM, all handovers will be hard. But between different sectors, that means within a same BTS, we require to provide a handover between antennas. So we have a softer handover category. So this is known as handover. For continuous mobility, mostly we have these type of handover between inter BTS handover. So we also have one more handover category, and that is known as intra BTS handover. So, intra BTS. Intra means within, and inter means different. Within the same BTS, we require to have a handover. That means between sector itself. So, if we are providing a handover between sector, different BTS, so we have different BTS, inter BTS. Same BTS, intra BTS. So these are the categories of handovers. After that we have intra BSC and inter BSC handover. Within the same BSC, we are providing a handover. All of these BTS are under the same BSC, but two different BSCs, two different BTS. So this type of handover is inter BSC. Within the same BSC, intra. Different BSC, inter BSC handover. Now next category is intra MSC, inter MSC. Within the same MSC, you are having a handover intra MSC. Same different MSCs, that means roaming cases, inter MSC handover. So after this, we have a intra frequency and inter frequency. Intra frequency, that means within the same frequency we are having a handover. So intra frequency. So but we require handover from GSM 900 to GSM 1800. So between two different frequencies, so we have inter frequency handovers. That means handovers are categorized according to the hardwares and according to the frequencies. So mainly we have hard handover, But we can categorize into number of parts. But remember that in GSM we have hard handover concept. Now one category that we normally say that we have seamless handover. Seamless handover are basically the handovers without breakage. That means passing from one to another. One to different. Seamlessly traveling. User is traveling without any call drop, without any session drop. Now, the topic is handover decision, that who is taking the handover decision. So, if this is my BTS, this is my mobile station, this is my BTS, it has to pass under this. So, here is my BSC. It could be same, it could be different. Now, all the location of the BTS, that means base station controller is a controller who is controlling a number of BTS under it. So that means information of BTS. This BTS do not know the nearby BTS. The information of all the BTS is under BSC. So when measurement reports pass to BTS, this will be passed to handover request will be passed to BSC. These BSC will find out the nearest whether TRX is available to accommodate a user or not. So it will check first. Then we have handover acknowledgement. This will evoke this BTS also. Now, all the requests will be passed to this BTS and it will take the mobile station. It will allocate a time slot and it will, the user will have an access under this. So that means this is a handover procedure, that who is taking the handover decision. The handover decision is taken by BSC because all of the location of the BTS is there with, or all of the information related to BTS is there with BSC. That's why we can say that handover decision is there with BSC. But we can see that it is a very time consuming process. So I can say that my handover latency is more. But I don't have any provision because I require to provide, I have a base station controller who is controlling the BTS. So I require to provide the information. I don't have any information with surrounding BTS and under this with BTS. So latency will be more. Automatically latency will be more. But this latency is reduced in case of 4G. We will discuss that also. So that means handover decision is there with BSC. Now, if handover is taking some time to occur, handover is taking some time, so what will be the resultant? We have handover failure. So, if I have handover failure, I may have call drop. Call drop is not basically related to handover. We have number of reasons for call drop. This is one of the reasons that handover failure will result in call drop. So what we require to analyze in case of handover? We require to analyze handover success rate. Now what is the success rate of the handover? For example, I have 100 handover requests and out of that I have 20 success. So that means my handover success rate is only 20%. Rest all 80 calls are dropped. I am in a very bad network area. So my handover success rate should be 98%. This is the key performance indicator. That means the maximum value you get achieve. Because you cannot get always 100% authenticated network. So we have target value that 98%. That okay, if call drop is 2%, is call drop at 2 to 5%, it's okay. If handover success rate is 95 to 98% is okay. But my handover success rate should not be 90%, it should not be 70% or below. My call drop should not be 20%, it should not be 50%. So we require to analyze these parameters whenever we are focusing towards handover, related to handover success, related to handover failure. So if we have a handover failure, why we have a handover failure? Why we require to check out the neighbors, define BSA is able to provide a handover to different BTS or not. So these are the parameters which are related to the handover, which we require to analyze in this. So this is all about our class of GSM handovers. So we will continue with our next topic in our next class. Thank you so much.